like to thank our colleagues, Angela Kinder and Jolanda, so much for the invitation to present a piece of our work here in this panel. It's a great honor and pleasure for us to be here and to share some of our thoughts with you. So in our presentation, or in our talk, we will bring in a different perspective than Johannes Angermüller and Claudia Lepping. What we will do is, can you hear me? Yeah. So what we will do is to think about subjectivity from a biography-theoretical perspective on the basis of our own research and teaching experiences in the field of translational migration studies. Let me say a few words about the concept of biography, because I think, I don't know if all of you know the debate about this theory, but it's I think important to, yeah, to understand what we are doing. So the biography-theoretical perspective opens up both a theoretical and methodological access to subjectivity. In biographical research, the concept of biography is conceived as a social construction which constitutes both social reality and the subject's words of knowledge and experiences, and which is constantly affirmed and transformed within the dialectical relationship between life history knowledge and experiences and patterns presented by society. The focus of biographical research is not only the reconstruction of intention entities, which is represented as an individual's life course, but the embeddedness of biographies in social structures. In the diverse field of biographical research, and there exist different schools, we situate ourselves theoretically as well as methodologically in the Frankfurt tradition of biographical migration studies, as it was developed by Ursula Arpitsch and Lena Loblocki in the last decade at the Department of Sociology here at Goethe University. So we treat the biographical research approach as a research perspective, revolving around a reconstructive research logic, and which refers to biography as a theoretical concept, as a historical empirical object, and as a complex methodological strategy.
Especially in the field of transnational migration studies, the biographical approach is well suited to empirical investigations of transnational migration processes because it offers us a way of empirically capturing the diversity, complexity, and transformational character of migration phenomena and of reconstructing them through biographical analysis. In our work, we combine the biographical research perspective with the so-called transnationalism approach. The transnationalism approach serves as a critique of the dominant idea, which sees migration as a one-way process that is limited in time and space, as a move from the from the country of origin to the country of reception. In addition, it criticizes concepts of space, of space in which the nation state is treated as the natural and secure container in which all social experiences take place. From our point of view, the transnationalism approach opens up new and challenging ways of understanding more profoundly the dynamics of migration processes without subsuming migrants immediately in the assimilative logics of the nation-state paradigm. It involves a different set of questions and factors that those traditionally taken into account by classical migration research.
The transnationalism perspective in migration studies was developed by scholars who have themselves a migration background or have been influenced in one way or the other by their personal experience with migration. Interestingly, this fact is not made visible in the mainstream theoretical discourse in migration sociology in Germany, neither in the historical reconstruction of the transnational turn in migration studies, nor by the leading scholars of the discourse themselves. Also, not in the field of biographical migration studies. So even though one would assume doing biographical migration research includes biographical reflection, however, its application takes seldom place and it's not a part of classical biographical analysis methodology. It seems as if there exists an invisible resistance against the articulation or not articulation of the own biographical entanglements with the research themes. the question why I do what I do and how this is linked with translational knowledge production remains in classical as well as translational migration theory and mainstream migration sociology invisible. While this is reflected in neighbor disciplinary discourses, for example, gender studies and cultural anthropology. Interestingly, in contrast to this mainstream, and I really say mainstream migration sociology discourse, in our seminars at the university, students who decided to focus on migration phenomena in their thesis make their own experiences with the topic of migration visible, especially those who have a migration background themselves. Family migration backgrounds are referred to more frequently and talked about more openly. The students justify their interest in the topic of migration with their own biographical migration experiences. However, it is not enough to say that migration experiences as such is a resource. The question is how this becomes to a resource. Therefore, it remains a challenge for the methodological debate in transnational biographical migration studies to reflect upon the researcher's subjectivity. How does the researcher's biography influence the translational research process? Our thesis is that not the migration experiences of the researcher, but the professional, methodologically controlled biographical reflection of these experiences plays a central role in translational knowledge production and in the field of migration studies.
But not only migration processes are characterized through transnationality, but the whole scientific knowledge production too. The globalization and transnationalization are influencing the production and circulation of scientific knowledge. Scientists as public intellectuals are engaged in scientific networks in which theories travel from one place to another. In the field of transnational migration studies, however, the tricky question is not only about the theories that travel, but about the researchers and theorists themselves who are engaged in knowledge production processes. What is the role of the researcher and his or her experiences in the research process while researching the emerging transnational social spaces? A look at the research done so far indicates that the majority of the researchers active in this field have their own bias, that means they have own experiences of migration. However, in most cases, this implicit knowledge is not openly articulated and methodologically reflected.
So we argue that this implicit knowledge needs to come under scrutiny. This means that the constitution of research design needs to be explicitly reflected in regard to the meaning of the researcher's experiences in the construction of the research field. The questions are how migration experiences influence the research done and the research perspective that has been taken. By underlining the need for biographical reflection, we acknowledge the situated nature of knowledge production and ask how experiences of the researcher, and in this case the experiences of migration, influence the research process and how the reflection on the subjective experiences can be considered as a productive means in doing research in translational research settings.
We argue that the key method in understanding the meaning of our migration experiences is the biographical reflexivity. We understand reflexivity in a sense of scientific reflexivity according to Pierre Bourdieu, who sees the reflexivity as a way to develop further the means of knowledge production. This means that the reflection of their own migration experiences becomes a part of the research process. With the help of the reflection of all migration experiences only, it's possible to make this knowledge productive in the research process. The reflection of all migration experiences can be done by formulating sensitizing concepts out of all migration experiences. I refer to these concepts can be furthermore capitalized in the sense in the research process by bringing those in abductive theory building process. This means that the sensitizing concepts that are generated through the biographical reflexivity become a part of interactive research process in which empirical knowledge is brought into a dialogue with multi-vocality of theories and experiences.
How should biographical reflection take place in a research process? In our research practice in the field of transnational migration, we develop following sheet to reflect the biographical entanglement in the research processes. We argue that the biographical reflection should take place in research working groups, so-called Forschungswerkstätte, in regard to the following questions. How have migration experiences influenced my life? How did I come to study the specific topic in the field of migration? What is my relationship to the topic research? How did I get access to the field? How does my own position influence the interaction in the field and the data collection process? What is my interpretation perspective? With the help of these questions, it is possible to generate sensitizing concepts from a biographical perspective. These concepts can be seen as a starting point to overcome national perspective and theory building and produce transnational theory perspective through the dialogue between theory and empirical field. At the best case, this concept can make sensitive for the research phenomena.
We would like to now clarify this with an example out of our research working group, the Forschungswerkstatt. We learned to know Sami, as we call him, when he started to work on his research project on transnational families. He grew up in a transnational migrant family, and his biography is characterized by commuting migration. He lived in a transnational social environment where he got sensitized for the question of transnational family migrations. In that social context, he realized that the public and political discourse differed from his experiences and perceptions about the question of transnational families. This motivated him to start a research project on transnational families from a biographical perspective. His access to the social field was facilitated by his transnational social networks, which enabled him to research a field that is very difficult to access to. In further research process, this closeness, however, became troubling, for example, in the process of interpretation. At that point, Sami felt unable to find the distance needed for the interpretation and categorization of the biographical narrative interviews that he had collected. The discussion of this problem in the transcultural research group led to the biographical reflection that enabled him to become aware of the meaning of his own subjectivity and its influence on the research process. It became obvious that it was important to make visible and show how the research process, as well as the interpretation process, was intertwined with his own biographical experiences and expectations. The explication became central part of the abductive theory building process in his work. Therefore, we argue that the migration experiences of the researcher, herself or himself, and the biographical reflection must be seen as part of the constitution of the research field. With the help of the concept of biographical reflexivity, it is possible to make visible the implicit biographical knowledge that is encased in these research processes. At the same time, biographical reflexivity should be seen as part of professional academic practice, and not just in the field of transnational migration studies, but in social sciences in general. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Nina.